Hello everyone, this is Leo from General Press. In this tutorial, we will be looking at the layout and spacing options available for the site header and primary navigation. It's going to be a longer video as there are many options to go through, so let's get started. For this demonstration, I will be using the options from the Menu Plus module and the Spacing module. I will also activate the Colors module as I find it easier to demonstrate some of the options, but you don't need to if you're just following along the video. We will be using the Flexbox structure available in GeneralPress 3.0 or above. Now we can head to Layout, Header. The first option we have is the header presets option. This option simply presets some header and navigation layout for you by changing the customizer options we will be going through, so I will not go through them in details here. Next, we have the header width and the inner header width options. Setting it to full will make the header container width 100% of the screen width. Setting it to contain will make the header container width the same as the content container width. The inner header width option would only work if the header width is set to full. So now you have the option to set the inner header width to full or contained. The header alignment option allows you to align the site title or logo if you're using one. I will change the header width option to contain again as it shows the header padding option a little bit better. The header padding option allows you to change the space around the header content. It also has mobile specific options, so we can set the top and bottom padding specifically for mobile screens. Or simply leave it blank so they inherit the desktop settings. We will skip the navigation as header option for now and come back to it later. Next, we have the mobile header option. This option disables the default site header on mobile devices, which looks like this, and replaces it with a streamlined version. You have the options to upload a logo image, or simply stick with the site title option. Then you have the options to make the mobile header sticky, an additional option to hide when scrolling down. Now let's take a look at the layout options for the primary navigation. The first option here is the mobile menu label. It allows you to change the text beside the toggle. Or you can remove the label and just use the toggle only. Then we have the mobile menu breakpoint slider. This allows you to change when the navigation goes from the desktop layout to the mobile layout with the toggle. Next, we have the navigation width and inner navigation width options. These are very similar to the header width and inner header width options introduced previously. Then we have the navigation alignment option, which again is similar to the header alignment option. Next, we have the navigation location option. It's currently set to below header, and we also have the option to set it above header, flow right, flow left, or put it in the sidebar. If you don't need a navigation, then you can simply remove it. Let's take another look at the float option. When this option is activated, you will see the addition of navigation drop point slider. To demonstrate this option better, I will first lower the mobile menu breakpoint. And you can see that as the window shrinks, the menu jumps to a second line, and it doesn't look good. We can improve it by setting a navigation drop point. So something like 1,000 pixel. Now let's take a look. The navigation now jumps down to the second line at 1,000 pixel and is centered automatically. This option is especially useful when you have lots of menu items, as it will get close to the site title or logo and jumps to the second line really quickly. I will change the mobile menu breakpoint back to 768, which is the default. And now we will head back to the header layout and revisit the navigation as a header option that we skipped earlier. This option is a little bit similar to the float option we have right now. The difference is that the logo or site title is now added inside the navigation, so basically combine the header and navigation. Let's take a look. I will say that this is one of the most popular options inside GP Premium. Now we will head back and take a look at the rest of the options. So next we have the navigation dropdown. Right now it's a hover. We also have click menu item. Or click arrow only. Then we have the drop down direction. It's default to right, or we can set it to the left. Then we can add a search icon inside the navigation. Then we have the menu item width slider. It also has mobile specific option. If you leave it blank, then it would inherit the desktop setting. Then we have the menu item height option. Again, we have the mobile specific option. Similarly, we have the submenu item height. And submenu width. Before we move on to the next section, I will increase the menu item height a bit. And then activate the navigation as a header option. And we will also use a logo this time. And hide the site title. Now let's take a look at the sticky navigation options. So you have the option to use sticky navigation for mobile only, desktop only, or both. Now let's go to a longer page so we can see the sticky navigation. Now let's take a look at the transition options available. By default, it's set to fade. Or we have the slide option. Or we don't have to use a transition. We can hide when scrolling down. And we can also upload a sticky navigation logo so the logo will change when the sticky navigation appears. The last option is the menu item height. So in primary navigation, we have the height set to 62 pixels. If we set a different height for the sticky navigation, let's say 50 pixels. Then you should see a cool transition here. The last set of options we're going to go through in this video is the off-canvas panel. I will use mobile only here as it's more commonly used. The first option we have is the slide. And as you can see, there's no menu items here. And that's because we haven't assigned a menu to the off-canvas panel yet. Now let's head back. Now we can see the menu items. We can choose which side it slides out from. And the location of the close button. The second style we have is the overlay style. It looks okay like this, but you should always try to set overlay default. Now I like to look much better. And of course we have again the menu item height option. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.